finally, let's talk about color management. And if you are wondering whether real lens flare can be used in your color manage project, the answer is yes. Real lens flare support ACES color management framework. The way to set up real lens flare to fit nicely in ACES color manage project is through the render settings section in the effect control panel UI. By default, the color mode is set to video, which means that real lens flare expects a color space and gamma within the video range like sRGB as its input. And the output of the lens flare produced will also be within the same sRGB color space and gamma. So if we want to fit real lens flare to ACES, then we need to set it to its linear ACES CG mode. Now, real lens flare is expecting ACES CG as its input, and it will also output ACES CG back as a result. Currently, in After Effects, the result of our lens flare looks very wrong. But that's just because we haven't set our color management properly inside After Effects. So let's do that. Let's open the After Effects project settings and select Color tab. Here we can see that the color engine is still set to Adobe Color Managed. We want to set this option to OCIO Color Manage, and as we do that, After Effects will give us a pop-up notifications, and you can simply just click OK to continue. Here, we can choose to use the OCIO configuration file that we like. I'm going with ACES 1.2. And now, we want to choose the working color space to do all of our compositing. The default ACES CG will be the best way to go. And finally, we want to select the display color space, or the color space that we are targeting for our output. Since I am working with an sRGB monitor, the default option ACES/sRGB is fine with me. And if you want to change it to something like Rec 709 Gamma 2.4 or DCI P3, then simply select it from the drop-down menu. So now let's hit OK to confirm our color management framework. Now we can see that our real lens flare is looking correct, but our footage doesn't. Remember, we have set our real lens flare to be working in ACES CG, but we haven't done that with our footage. We then need to inform our color management framework what type of footage that we have here. And the way to do that is simply by using the interpret footage and select main. Go to the color tab and select override media color space. Currently, we can see that we are telling our color management framework that this footage is living in ACES 2065-1 color space, which is not the case. This is a Rec 709 or sRGB footage, so what we can do is to open the dropdown and select Output Rec 709 or Output sRGB. Notice as I change the color space, the footage starts to look correct right away. Let's hit OK. In our color managed project, it is necessary to always inform the color management framework what type of material we are bringing into our working space. And now, you are ready to go to tweak real lens flare to your liking, and you will be doing so in ACES CG within After Effects. So that's setting up color management inside After Effects, but what about inside Resolve? So let's head to DaVinci Resolve then. In DaVinci Resolve, the color management settings can be accessed to the File menu and select Project Settings, or by clicking the small gear icon at the bottom right. Once the Project Settings window is open, go to the Color Management tab. In the Color Science dropdown, you can opt to select DaVinci YRGB Color Manage or the two versions of ACES, the ACES CC or ACES CCT. You can definitely use Real Lens Flare within DaVinci YRGB Color Manage, but that will require some color space transformations within the workflow that you can easily do with color space transform nodes. In this example, however, I would like to showcase the ACES color management framework. So let's select ACES CCT. And let's use the newest version of ACES, ACES 2.0. And I will leave ACES AMF empty. And I will set ACES input transform to red log 3G10 red white gamut RGB, since we only have one clip in this project and that clip was acquired in red white gamut. If you have multiple clips, you can leave this to no input transform and later on tag your clip separately from the media pool. I want to target sRGB gamma 2.2 as my ACES output transform, since this is the display space that I'm using for this example, and most probably also the display color space and gamma that you are using to view this content. And now, I can leave everything else in default and I'll hit save. As we confirm the project settings, the clip should look correct right away. And by the way, if you have multiple clips and you've set the input transform to no input transform, you can simply right-click the clip on the media pool and select ACES Input Transform and choose the camera color space and the transfer functions accordingly. So now, let's open the Fusion page. And here, you can simply add Real Lens Flare to your node setup. Simply press Shift Spacebar and type in Real Lens Flare and hit Add. In Real Lens Flare, scroll down to the render settings and change the color mode to Linear ACCG and your flare will look correct right away. You can now then tweak your flare or browse for some presets that you like. Fusion page is working in linear, so setting the project color management to ACCCT, which has log transfer function, will automatically transform ACCCT log transfer function to linear, which allow Real Lens Flare to fit right away. And since the processing of Fusion page will be before the edit and the color page, the result of our Real Lens Flare will also look correct if we switch to edit or color page. Okay, so now let's delete Real Lens Flare in Fusion and let's apply it in the color page. Let's also switch the color mode to Linear ACCG. Since we are working with an ACCCT, the color page will be working in log environment. And since our Real Lens Flare requires a linear environment, the result of our Real Lens Flare will look wrong. And to remedy this, we can do a simple transformation before and after the Real Lens Flare node. Let's add a node before and after, and let's drop in ACES Transform OFX to these two nodes. Before Real Lens Flare, I want to switch the input transform to ACCCT and the output transform to ACCG. And on the last node, I want to set the input transform to ACCG and the output transform back to ACCCT. So what we are doing here is changing our grading environment, which is in log, to fit the requirement of our Real Lens Flare, which is in linear with node number 1. And finally, with the node number 3, we are transforming back from linear to log. Now, I can start changing and tweaking Real Lens Flare and the result will be accurate. Now if we click the Fusion page, you'll notice that we don't have our Real Lens Flare since the Fusion page is preceding the color page. But if we switch to edit page, we will get our Lens Flare result. Although the locations of the edit page is preceding the color page, the edit page will take the output from the color page and view the changes made in the color page accordingly. So, there you go. That's how you can use Real Lens Flare in Resolve within an ACES color managed project. My take on this, I would use Real Lens Flare within Fusion page to have all the flexibility and the simplicity, but you have all the choices. Feel free to experiment and play around with it. So, that's it folks. That is Red Giant Real Lens Flare. Use it to your advantage to create a super realistic lens flare in post. I hope that this video tutorial helped you understanding Real Lens Flare better. Don't forget that you can also download the flares that we create during this tutorial as presets that you can load right into your Real Lens Flare project. If you ever need to know the exact details of what each parameter in Real Lens Flare does, do feel free to check out the user guide in Maxon website. There, you'll find a complete documentation of Real Lens Flare that can help you understand the tool even better. My name is Max from Maxon Training Team. Thank you very much for tuning in. Until next time, goodbye.